To everybody, I am Professor A.U. Patel, advisor. Welcome you all on this webinar, and particularly Professor Dr. Bharat B. Maitreya, who is our guest speaker today. We have started this series on advice of our Honorable Director Nagarajan Sahib, for the benefit of the students, particularly in difficult subjects and emerging technology. Because regular colleges and universities are now not working because of the COVID-19, and it is spreading very fast. So in near future also, we have to use this technology. Dr. Bharat B. Maitreya is a professor in botany at Gujarat University. He is a research guide, particularly in botany, bioinformatics, climate change, impact management, environment science and horticulture sciences. He is in Department of Botany since long. His work is extraordinary, particularly in phytochemistry, chemical and research on plant series. He is expert as far as his subject is concerned, particularly specialization in phycology. His PhD thesis also on specialization, river, flora, plant diversity. He submitted large number of research projects and he attended many programs also. Delivered expert lectures, more than 30, and he is also one of our guest speaker at BISEC. 21 lectures, video lectures, he has given to BISEC, and students are listening on TV also, on website also. So he is one of our best expert available among universities of Gujarat. I welcome him on behalf of the KCG and on behalf of the Department of Education, and particularly our Principal Secretary, Mrs. Sanju Sharma. We know that Gujarat University stands today unique and number one among all universities of Gujarat. In national ranking also, our university, Gujarat University, is scored within 100, and university started large number of research projects, startups, innovations, incubation center, and so on. I also welcome our participants, those who are from various colleges and universities, and others who are not even in academic field, they are also interested in this subject. I think that this subject itself is very good, because it is the study of chemicals produced by plants, particularly in the secondary metabolizes, synthesizes, and measure for self defense against insects, pests, pathogens, etc. So this subject, particularly phytochemistry, takes into account the structural compositions of this metabolism and help even in medical drug preparation and certain other fields also. So I am not expert in this field, but on reading note, I found that this is a very important subject for human being, and it is a very advantageous. It can help even cosmetic industries, clothing, textiles industry, food, wine, beverages industries, and military, among others. So with this brief introduction, I can say that this is a very important subject, and Dr. Bharat will explain more because he is expert. I request all of you to pay attention till to the last minute, so you will understand this subject better. Again, I welcome you all and thank you very much.
Thank you so much, A.O. Patel sir, for your gentle words. Proceeding with our today's session, I would like to request Bharat sir to continue with the session.
Thank you. Thank you, KCG, and especially thanks to advisor of KCG, Dr. A.U. Patel sir, and Education Department, Gujarat State, those who give me the opportunity in this webinar series of Leading Future Technology. Generally, all the science subject or other subjects experts in nowadays this COVID situation or post-COVID situation. So mostly the online classes which are going on and knowledge gathering by this online process which are continuous from various colleges and universities. So in this situation, our education department and also our education system give us this opportunity. So by this online mode that we are dealing with our education part, our education system, either it is in academic admin or maybe some examination system. So this process which are going on, and as well as besides of our university syllabus, theory practical works, so some expert lectures for the not in our part, our department, but all the various colleges and departments of the state or other universities in this by the means of the social media. So we can have this opportunity to have some knowledge regarding to our subject, either it is in academic way or maybe research way. So thank you, sir. Today in botany subject, phytochemical and pharmacological research on plant species, a traditional knowledge and science. So mostly in our botany subject, especially in science, so there are two kind of academic way, whether it is in basic knowledge of the particular science subject or maybe applied knowledge of the particular subject. So generally up to the our graduation or the master level, most of the syllabus content which we have which give a knowledge of some basic science subjects, subject content. But in some universities, in final year master level courses, some kind of dissertation works, those who promote the research works, research dissertations. So some scientific problems and their solutions by the research guide or maybe academic staff to the final year students. And from that part, our science students deals with the research activity. Mostly, particularly all the science subjects in science faculty, various subjects like physics, chemistry, microbiology, zoology, botany, etc. But in all the subjects, when you see the syllabus of that part, so more than 50 or 55 different kind of this content topic titles are there in as a unit-wise in syllabus. If regarding to our subject botany, so mostly from this our cryptogams botany to phanerogams to cytology to genetics to ethnobotany to taxonomy to plant physiology to plant biochemistry, plant ecology to phytogeography, and this like subject where in various units we are distributed and give the content and the particular knowledge regards to this unit content. In Gujarat University, Department of Botany, Bioinformatics and Climate Change Impact Management, when I joined there as a professor and also a research guide in the various science subjects, botany to bioinformatics, climate change, horticulture science and environmental science. So our new budding scientists, those who pass out their MSc examinations, their PET examination, either it is from this NET or SLET examination or JRF, SRF, so they are willing to join a research program in our department. And in botany department, related with this plant science, and all the others applied topics, either deal with the cytology with the plant, the genetic study with the plants, phytochemistry study with the plants, ecology with the plant, all the subjects we are having in department. Most of the students from MSc level to PhD level, so they are dealing with their different subjects either in our department or various research institutions of the Gujarat state, where the particular subject experts and other infrastructures, laboratories which are there, if it's deal with this pollution control board, either it is in GIR Foundation, either it is Gujarat Environment Management Institute is there, either it is a BISEC, either is the PRL, either is the ISRO. So these are the all the various institutions, research institutions where the, our students are going there and do their research work. In a plant science, today's topic where they deals with the phytochemistry and pharmacological point of view. So in our tradition, so in our society, I'm not saying that all the peoples of this our state or all the population, those who are having the knowledge of the botany, but all the people of our state or nation or as a worldwide, I'll say, so they have a little bit knowledge about the plant. We are observing the plant surrounding us, either in garden or maybe as a roadside avenue trees, or maybe if you go anywhere that you observe the plant, you even know the name of the plant, but you observe this plant and the plant species. If we feel uncomfort or we are suffering from the such kind of disease, so at that time, that as a this plant material, which are surrounding to our home part or maybe in our kitchen. So there are some various plant parts we are used to cure or take a relief for a while from that part. So a little bit knowledge which are gathering or maybe which are given by our elders or friends or somehow some remedials and some books, some knowledge from social sites. So we have such knowledge regarding to this, some plant which have some medicinal properties and it's deal with that. We know the plant science, the plant. So today in my this topic, generally the working observation for this plant species, generally most of the plant organs or maybe plant parts due to this some environmental conditions, mostly in some season we found there's some plant which are having much more leaves on it, but during the leaf fall period, so mostly the leaves are fallen down. This situation we know. Most of the plant which have a flowering in a whole year, but sometimes some plant species which having a very few times to produce the flower part, and after that is produce the fruit part. So now the summer season which are now start, and we are waiting for the some delicious fruit like mango. So even in a year, so we have this kind of fruit because of the flowering in a year, and particularly from December to March, this Mangifera indica or mango tree plant which have a flowers and then fruit. So like that, most of the plant which have a flowering in a once in a year. So this kind of condition is that during this phenological portions is the life event, we have all these kind of situations observes, and as a botanist, so we have keen interest to study the particular plant species and the phenomenon regarding to this lifespan and this various kind of this phenological activity we noticed. And this observation which gave the some kind of this ignition or this fight for to going for the research works during that part. So mostly the plant growth, seed germination, then growth and development is there, branching is there, then new leaf arise from the plant, then after that in a particular part the reproductive organs like the flowers they produce. Then after this fertilization process, pollination and fertilization process, the ripening of the ovary which give towards to the particular fruit part, the seeds which are within the fruit condition is there, and then this fruit after that the dehiscence of this fruit, the seeds which are dispersed, the seeds in a favorable condition which are germinate and give a new plant. So this is the lifespan of that part. And we also observe the different kind of the part of the plant, either it is a root, either it is stem. In a larger tree we see the trunk part, we see the bark portion is there, we found this branching is there, we found the leaves which are on the branching part. In flowering season we see the flowers, then after fruits, then the seeds. So in various plant species, the various kind of this plant organ which we are familiar with it. Mostly our keen interest to go the outside or maybe some kind of this traveling by bus, by train or everywhere when we are going to for our entertainment or maybe for particularly as a botany part for the study. So we observed a different kind of location, different kind of area is there. In our botanical terminology, we said in our plant ecology, these are all various ecosystems. So when we found that a well, which are the ecosystem, a lake, which are ecosystem, a spring is ecosystem, pond, rivers, and these are all these well having a fresh water in it. So these are the fresh water ecosystem is there. Also, we are going to in a coastal part or maybe some kind of sea source, coastal area. So we found that where there is a rocky coast, there are some kind of the sand dunes also present there. Some estuary portion is there where this major part of the river which are into this particular sea or maybe ocean. Then the salt marsh is there, the sea and ocean, coral reefs, these are the, all this in a marine ecosystem where the saline water condition is there. So in a major part of this on the earth, where the 80% of the ocean which are covered up by this water condition, water habitat, where the, you found this fresh water and saline or marine water condition, these are all we are saying that ecosystem. It provides some habitat to particular habit structure, particularly living organism or living life. Also in a terrestrial portion that we found that grassland, there are the forest, there are the mountain area, there are desert, there are agricultural fields we have some urban ecosystem also and some village ecosystem. So these are all these various kind of habitat where the particular kind of the plant which are habit structure in it. And we found that each and every place, either we are going to the mountain area where the rock area is there. So most of the plants which are having a lithophyte condition, which are grown well as there. Also, we found that semophyte in sandy area. We found this halophyte in the coastal area. So these are the condition where the particular plant which are growing in particular ecosystem. When we classify the plant, because generally those who are not related with the botany subject, only they observe the plant. So they said there are larger trees, the one trunk and this crowns part are there. There are larger leaves, flowers and fruit. But if we studied about the botany subjects and if we are classified according to their structures, their particularly this characteristics, and they produce the flowers or maybe some kind of the cell structures, some kind of this body structure, some kind of the reproductive part. So along with this, all the characteristics we describe and we classify it in a different classification system. So in from early stage of this, where the origin of life or maybe origin of this our earth portion in this our cosmos, where this all the plant parts, either it is from the unicellular portion to the multicellular organism which we have, a very tiny material or tiny living organism to the macro or larger size of this which have plant we are having. So in that portion, so we have classified a different kind of plant. So from basic, the primary kind of this plant, where they also we have saying that some cyanophyte like this algae, then carophyte and algal portion, where they, we have a fungi part, we have also lichen, some bryophytes, then pteridophytes, gymnosperm, angiosperms, and these are all these some kind of this, either it is from the water body portion or land plant, vascular plant or seed or without seeded plant. These are all the plants we are classified according to their characters. Generally, in our world and our nation, though approximately the non-plants which we have, before that some microorganisms like bacteria and viruses also living organism is there. But as a plant part we are saying, so we have 40,000 algae and 6,500 algae in it, around our India. approximately 72,000 fungi involved, and in 14,500 fungi which are known in our nation. Also, we have 2,000 lichens in our nation, approximately 3,000 bryophytes, 1,100 pterophytes, 64 gymnosperms, and more than 17,000 angiosperms, which are reported in our state. Reported means non-part. Mostly the botanists, or those who are having a knowledge about the plant science, those who explore the such areas and go to there and find out this particular plant species and try to identify it. And they are identify the particular plant species and they reported all this plant part to the recognized institutions. And after the recognition, which we have our authentic plant name, plant part, and we count these numbers of the plant in our this vegetation world. A different kind of the algae part, because this kind of this morphological or biodiversity of the particular plant, this photograph which are having, it is a very less photos of particular some algae, but they, you as observe some differences or some diversity among the particularly one group of the plant which are known as the algae. Apne jene Gujarati ma lil kahiye chhe. Then the fungi portion. Mostly in a fungi, so we know the most of the fungi which gives us a particular kind of disease in it. But most of the fungi also have important part. They produce some kind of enzymes also. Some kind of this edible fungi, we know the mushrooms, which know the some edible mushroom, we know. Then the bryophytes. So mostly, jene Gujarati ma dvihangi kahiye chhe, mostly found in the moist area. Jyan bech vadhare hoy, tyan jova malta hoy chhe. So these are the bryophytes which are found in the parts, like in classification system, it's onwards, leverworts and mosses there. Also, at pteridophytes. Gujarati maane three angi kevama aave chhe. Tron angi rachna dharave chhe, which have a root, stem and leaves. But it is a non, generally seedless plant, which have no any kind of seed structure in it. So this allogenera, pteris, triopteris, adiantum and equisetum. So these are the pteridophytes. And our ancient in epic, the poetries like Rama and Mahabharata, where they mention the different kind of plants, where in a such situation where the Sanjeevani, which are taken by this our Lord Hanumanji during the 74 sag of this Yudhakanda in Ramayana. So during that part, he went to this Himalaya range and then brought up this Sanjeevani plant. And for the unconscious Lakshmana, you for their consciousness, and then they give this life for that part. So we know this episode of for that part. So it's believed that this Sanjeevani plant, which belongs to this Allogenera bryopteris plant, is there. So this kind of the pteridophytes, which are grown in a particular mountain range where the high altitude is there, where the low temperatures and this all this alkaloids or such kind of the phytochemical constituents or biomolecules which are retained, and mostly it is not evaporate more. Likewise, the gymnosperms also we found, we have some cultivated gymnosperms in our garden place, but also in some hilly area. So we found in a high altitude natural condition that most of the gymnosperms which are growing there. And larger group of the plant which are surrounding us, like we call it the angiosperms, where we are classified into monocots and dicots. So according to the classification systems, they are divided into two groups, monocot and dicot. So these are the differences between the monocots and dicots. Here, a typical kind of the flower structures which we have. So generally the calyx, corolla, then androecium, gynoecium. These are all the various plant parts, those who have studied the botany subjects. So they have knowledge about the all these plant parts. Also, the structures of the some pollen, which are look like this coronavirus, but it is not a coronavirus, but it's a pollen. Mostly this from this. If you see this datura fruit, is also look like that because some kind of this spiny structure surrounding wall in this fruit wall, and some also some kind of this textures in pollen wall we find. So mostly the exob part of this pollen, which are having this kind of structures, we found. Also we have the flower structures and the reproductive portion, reproductive parts is there after the pollination and fertilization, that we have some kind of this fruit structures. So it is a ripening ovary. So before this ripening ovary, the ovule portion, which are in the part of that flower structures, after that it's become a fruit structures, and this ovule become a seed in it. So this picture show the how the flower part having the this process of the pollinations, then after the fertilization, then ripening ovary, and this ovary become a fruit part, and this seeds, and after this seeds, either it is a decayed, dehisced, and then disperse all the seeds, and in favorable condition, these seeds which are germinate and give a new plant to it. So these are all the slides which I have shown to you for the little bit the knowledge about the plant, but particularly plant diversity, where the various kind of the plant parts, various kind of the plant types are there, and mostly our keen observation to have some knowledge regarding to plant science. Here on this, mostly from this Asteraceae family which we have, so some kind of this after that this fruit part, after it's dehisced, which are the dry fruits, which having this some kind of seeds, and the seeds which are surrounded by the some this feather like structures, and it is a high structures, and which are give these seeds in the wind conditions, so that disperse is in a larger area and larger scale, it's travel by this the wind structures. So it's disperse the seeds in a larger area, and it produces plant species and grow plant species. So this is particularly plant life cycle. Our botany students, those who are studied about the various kind of life cycle of the plants, so they know the particularly vegetative part of the plant, and after this vegetative part, where the all these portions where the reproductive part is there, and after the reproductions the fruit and seed condition is there, and they give the new generation to it. So haploid to diploid condition, diploid to haploid condition, the line life span, there are the two sporophytic or gametophytic stage which are occurs. So in a plant life cycles, so these are the vegetative and reproductive part which are have. Among this plant species, some plant species which have the recreational values, I say that almost all the plant which having a recreational value, because they provides food, fodder, fruit, fuel, timber, medicine. Mostly some plant which have a commercial value, like the oil or fertilizers which are extracted from the species. Some biological value we have, that like the pollination, then soil formation and nutrient enrichment. Ethical value, generally it is not can be measured in terms of money. The aesthetic value is art, poetry and literature. We have most of this in this literature portions. We know this some plant part and then information regarding to that. The scientific value, the gene pool, evolution and human welfare. Mainly we are these intellectuals and we are learned persons, and among this all these animals, the human being which have a different kind of this category, and there's all the part, and as far as the condition of this intelligency and the well developed this brain and well behaved this living organism among them. So for our welfare, or maybe other domestic animal or wild welfare, so we understand the knowledge about the plants. If there are the growth, development, growing of the plant, we are observe this plant, we are sowing the plant, we are cultivate this plant species. But if, in that particularly plant world, we have also noticed that some kind of plant species which we are extinct before the many years. Some kind of these plant parts were become endangered. Some plant species were vulnerable. Some plant species which found are very rare. Some indeterminate, and generally these are the plants where we are listed in our trade data book. So most of the plant part, where there some plant species, very beautiful flower, or which having lots of this pharmaceutical or maybe some kind of phytochemical constituents, biomolecules. So population is more, but this plant species is very less. So day by day they are using, they are utilized, they are vanished all this plant. And one day it happened that this plant species becomes extinct from this this world. Also we know this Ravantad, particularly this endemic plant species, where the in particular area we found this kind of the plant. The Google which we have surveyed, and most of the hilly tract like in our Junagadh, Girnar, and then in our Kutch area, we found that plant part, but very less plant, because they have a very religious values and some religious function that we are using this particular plant. So particular resins which obtained from this Google plant. So it is not like that the people, though they want the particular resin from it, but they took the, all this plant part, or maybe some kind of people, those who are having particularly plant species, they cuts off from the root or the ground they were part. So this species day by day it's vanished for that. We have some very rare species like this bower tree, the Adansonia digita, and also this kind of structure. So we have also these plant species there. If in a world there plant life which are going there, new plants which are growing, but also at some level that also there are the threats to the plant species. Either it is by the habitat destructions, either it is by the pollution, either it is by species introduction, either it is by global warming, either it is by climate change, and it is not like that is in fluctuation in a short while, but there is a longer period if there are the climate change conditions, so they affect on this plant species and the exploitation. So these are the some kind of these particularly we found that these are the threats contained which we have this activity by the, either it is in a natural activity, natural calamities, or maybe some kind of anthropogenic structures. So in a plant state that this kind of conditions. So the benefit of the plant, the new food sources, the grain, fruit, vegetable, etc., medicine and oxygens. Before this COVID condition, because particularly before this March 20, we are not aware about this coronavirus or COVID and this post-COVID condition. So generally the lockdown condition we have unlocked situation 1 to 5 level, and now we have some in this year from March, so this corona transmission is much more within it. But we realize during that time, because during this lockdown, which we are all those family members in within the our home, where we are having no any kind of any works, no any going outside for our different work. But after that, so we have to fight against the coronavirus. So we did some our immune system pattern. So we found some plant part or maybe some plant species, those will boost our immune system. So during that part, so lots of people, those were used the different plant parts which enhance or maybe some kind of increase the immune system of our body. So a different kind of kadas, different kind of the syrups, different kind of this juice which we makes from the different kind of plants. So during this situation, because we are not suffering from any disease, but for this disease protection, we are going for some immunobooster plant. So we are think that we gather the knowledge regarding to some plant part which boost our immune system. So plant as an immunobooster, the new tradition which we are developed during the last 1 year, and most of the research works regarding to this part. Because plant contained some chemical constituents or some biomolecules which are having some content regarding to cure the some disease, but not in a proper way or not completely cure the disease. But before that, if you have a very well immune system, so you can know any kind of disease that it makes. If any kind of disease you have, so easily you can protect from that kind of these foreign bodies, either it is a virus or maybe bacteria. So at that time that we need most of the vegetables part, we have some fruit parts, some dry fruit part, some kind of this wild species also. During the last years, most of the medicinal stole or maybe some kind of the those who are having this health drink, they are prepared. So they want this giloy plant. Gujarati majane apne giloy kahiye chhe, Tinospora cordifolia. Because this plant which have this very well this immune system which give our immune system better. So this plant which are used. Likewise that also we are using turmeric, હેલ્ધી કહીએ છીએ, એ જ પ્રમાણે આપણે સોઠનો ઉપયોગ એટલો કરતા થયા છે, ગંઠોડા પાવડરનો ઉપયોગ આપણે એટલા કરતા થયા, જેઠી મધનો ઉપયોગ આપણે એટલા કરતા થયા છે, ઇલચીનો ઉપયોગ, તજ છે, લવિંગ છે, મરી છે, દિસ આર ઓલ ધી પ્લાન્ટ પાર્ટ્સ વિચ આર યુઝ ફોર અવર બેટર ઇમ્યુન સિસ્ટમ. સો રિગાર્ડિંગ ટુ ડેટ પાર્ટ, દિસ ફોટોગ્રાફ વિચ આર બેટર ફોર અવર હેલ્થ લાઈક ઇન ધીસ કોરોના વર્લ્ડ. Also, we know the plant phenological part. Plant phenology is a part where the different kind of this lifespan or maybe different kind of the producing part of the plants. So where this, if you regarding to this phenogram, that where this vegetative bud formation is there, emergence of inflorescence is there, the leafing is there, flowering, fruit formation, then fruit maturation and leaf fall. These are the conditions where the mostly the vegetative part of the plant having. But in this reproductive phases, where the flowering, fruit formation and fruit maturations. So after that, these part where the fruit part after the decayed condition or dehiscence condition or seed dispersal condition, they produce the flowering part. In this phytochemical and pharmacological ocean. So it is have like that in a phenology, because in a lifespan of the plant, either it is an annual, either it is a biennial, either it is a perennial plant lifespan, but each and every stage, so there are we are found that there are some kind of differences to production of the various kind of these biomolecules or biochemical constituents in plant. Also we found the season wise the different kind of chemical constituent in it. So it is not like that is a particular plant. Like I almost say that we know the each and every home that we are planted a tulsi plant, Osimum sanctum is there. in this Osimum Sanctum. So regarding to this various kind of the season, like now the summer season will start and up to the March, April end and then May month. So we have this high temperatures surrounding us. So atmosphere become dry. Temperature and the surrounding area is very hot. Evaporation rate is very high. So during that portion and during the daytime where the temperature rises, so these are give a particular impact on the leaves of the tulsi plant. So the aromatic oil or essential oils or different kind of the alkaloids which are present in a particular leaf or stem portion, so it's become evaporate due to this atmospheric condition, due to the high temperatures, due to this dry atmosphere surrounding. But in a winter season where the temperature is low, but there are no any humidity. But during this monsoon season, we found that our homely this tulsi plant, which have much leaves, much larger leaves, much greeny leaves. So no any kind of the leaf falls, but the healthy plant, the wealthy plant, which we have in the monsoon season, because the temperature is very low, the surrounding, there are the humidity, the evaporation rate, which are very less. So these are the condition which we have. So the, all the plant parts, which are in a particular atmosphere or particular habitat. So regarding to this longitude, latitude, altitude. So these are the all this part which are impact on the plant portion of or the chemical part of the particularly plants. So these are the all the content regarding to the plant life, information regarding to plants, because most of the our botany students, those who have a knowledge about this basic and applied knowledge of the botany subject, but those who are not having a much knowledge about the plant science, so I give the brief of the particular plant to all of them. So now this topic which having some basic content, the traditional medicinal knowledge, the contribute modern medicinal knowledge. Because generally and here I took this some content regarding to this our plant part, not in a botany part, but it is a some this medical faculty way where this all this in human being, there's like the diagnosis or maybe some kind of the curing portions during that portion. So from that allopathic to ayurvedic to Unani to homeopathic, from the physiotherapic part, so there are the different faculties or different kind of the subjects regarding to this medical sciences there. So when we talk about the Ayurveda, so where the Ayur means life and Veda means the knowledge. So generally, which kind of this knowledge for our life, betterment of life? So in the past, where there no any new technology is there. Nowadays, we have a lots of technology, the high technology value. Now this webinar series, they are leading this future technology in a part of that part. We have some social sites, social media is there, various kind of the our application is there, new technology, mobile technology, then our web link is there, net internet connections. So we gather all the knowledge regarding to that in a few seconds. We distribute all this information within a few seconds. We gather the knowledge in a few seconds. But in ancient times, there are no any kind of this technology. Because if you have to communicate, so the person, those who are going there and give particular one to this passage, and during that time also the language is a major problem for that portion is also there. Our this old, all this literatures which we found regarding to plant science and all this our some religious or the spiritual some content to be found it in a Sanskrit language, either it is in a Pali language, either it is in the Farsi language, in the Persian language. So these are the basic some knowledge, some Latin words, some Greek words, which are have in this particular plant part. Ayurveda, in that particularly we say it, that it is not harmful for us if any kind of the disease, if you want to cure it, so we go for this Ayurvedic particular treatment for that. And those practitioners, those who are known as the Vaidyas, those who treat us and diagnosis part, either it is a curing part, so these are the condition is there. And mostly they use the plant part, either it is a raw material, either it is a crude part from this plant portion is there. Mostly in a post Vedic era, where they do the mostly the in a medical science, where they properly medicinal the informations in Charak Sanhita, and this all the surgery in portion of this medical science like the Sushruta Sanhita, which give the particular knowledge regarding to medical science, and also which keep interest to have a knowledge of the plants. Ashtanga Hridaya, which also give the some basic knowledge and the traditional knowledge of the plant part. Mostly some plant which having the some medicinal properties, and they have some kind of this curing content in it. So it is mentioned in Rig Veda, in the Yunani Paddhati, so where this mostly the Arab countries, those who are having in 7th and 8th centuries, they have this kind of structures, and mostly they are metals and some minerals they are used to cure the some diseases of. So mostly the gold part, iron part, or maybe some kind of others, all the metals those who have, and from that part, so these metals they cure this particular disease from this kind of this medicinal practice. We have also this homeopathy, and also some Materia Medica book which we have, where the we gather the knowledge of the particular plants regarding to medicinal properties. The Siddha system, the Asht Siddha, Atprakarna Siddha, and Mote Bhage Khas Karine the Tri Dosha Prakriyache, Kapha Vata and Pitta. So this kind of this particularly in a particular human being which we are suffering from this any kind of this portion, so it's cure by this kind of this particularly, where the all this all Tibetan this tradition, or maybe some Chinese tradition, the Korean tradition, some Arab countries, some Afghan, or maybe some kind of this German, or maybe from European condition. So these are all these various tradition where they are having such knowledge regarding to medicinal science. In our ancient and largest this epic poetry like that Ramayana and Mahabharata, also there are mentioned more than 150 plant species from in various kind of the situation or various span of that particularly this Rama, Sita or Lakshman, and then the up to the Yodhakand. So we felt that mostly in that particular portion it is give information regarding to plants in that. Also in the Mahabharata, where there's some kind of the serpent, those who are the bites to the particular person, and the Vaidyas or Rishis, those who are give them a particularly plant paste or plant part for the curing of that particularly the bites of these snakes or serpent. So these are the things which we have some knowledge. So regarding to that, I not give the much content from this part, because all these materials, all this particular content which are having with us mostly, the all this material or content you found from our website, and also if most of the person those who are having little bit knowledge regarding to medicinal plants, or maybe they hold some kind of this diagnostic part and then this cure part. So if they have to particularly making of this some kind of these juices or some kind of the crude part for the curing of their not a severe disease but some kind of disease. So they are used all those things. Regarding to our biological part, when we deal with the biochemistry, also it is a chemical science, but it's deal with these living organisms and some kind of chemical structures, where they, if it is originate, if it is a conversion, or it is a manufacture, or it is produced by in a different way. So it's a play major role in it. Either it is all these living organisms, either it is the microorganisms, or either it is a plant part, either it is an animal, either it is in a human being, domestic animals or maybe wild animals, each and every part, where this all the physiological activities there, all the metabolic activity, anabolic and catabolic activities there. So generally this kind of this chemical constitutions, the chemical formula, this more and more derivatives we found in it. So the foundation of the biochemistry, which deals with this, the cellular foundation, the cell structures which are within it, the chemical foundation, physical foundations, and also genetic foundation and evolutionary foundation. So some kind of this contained regarding to this biochemistry part. This term biochemistry, look by this simple word itself, but when you deal with this subject, so you found this lots of these biochemical constituents you have, various kind of this reaction actions which are raised with this living organism day by day. Regarding to that, our plant part, which deals with the pharmacological study, where the particularly when we talk about the medicines, either it is in artificial way, either it is from the natural part, either it is an endogenous molecule which accept a biochemical or physiological effect on the cell, tissue, organ, etc. Also, these chemical constituents, by their uses, of their effects, and the mode of action of drugs. Because in a primary condition, which we are not saying that this is a proper drug, which we are this particular chemical constituents which are obtained from the plant, which are known as a drug. But all this kind of, because if we are taking a plant part, then we extract some materials and we analyze all these things, then identification it there. If we the application for this particular part, and also application to the particularly the suffering from the severe diseases, and we apply to them, and after that we get the results, then we say this is all the drugs. Otherwise some kind of the little bit this contained, which are cures, a little bit is cured of that particular portion. So in this pharmaceutical study, so medicinal portion is there, also uses effect and the mode of action of for the drugs which are studied. Also content of the some metabolites during that plant life cycles within it. So we are having a knowledge about the phytochemistry. So if we have a little bit or basic knowledge about the phytochemistry, then we deal with the phytochemical study, the method of plant analysis. Generally, all the plant parts in the lifespan, the physiological activity is going there. Mostly we said that photosynthesis is there, respiration is there, plant growth and development is there. Lots of the plant growth hormone which are manufactured, produced within the plant. We have the plant growth regulators within it. We have a different kind of enzyme. Day by day it's produced during the different kind of this living conditions or situation or production of the particular organs. So these are the all the physiological activity within the plant which are going on. So for the study of this phytochemistry, so we need that method of plant analysis. So what it needs, because generally in a plant part, So we know the plant which have a root, shoot, then after that growth of the shoot part, we have a stem, branching, then a leaf which arises from this branching portions, then apical bud, either it is a lateral bud is there, they produce the branching or maybe leaf stretches, then after in they produce the reproductive structures which known as a flower, then this flower condition gives a fruit, then fruit gives the seed and seed after the germination process. So from root part to seed part. So these are the different kind of plant parts in a plants. So mostly we know for the particular plant part which we are used as the medicinal properties, because not all this plant which have all plant parts used for cure over some kind of disease or some kind of immune booster plant or some kind of tonic to us. Because when you know that if you have a tulsi plant, then you chew the leaf of that particular plant. If different kind of this, all the spices structures you found. So if you have a clove, the clove plant, which is nothing but a loving creation, these are the particularly these inflorescence spores of that particular flower bud which we are saying. If we have some kind of the turmeric portion is there, so we have the rhizome structure in it, either it is in a particular rhizome part, either it is a wet condition or maybe dry condition, or either it's by the making of the powder of it we are used it, some kind of the fruit part we are used, like in this elaichi portion, the cardamom which we are used, it is a fruit part. Also some this cinnamon zelenicum, tajpatra je ap kahe chhe, tadna patta kahe chhe, tamal patra kahe chhe, eni je chhal chhe eno apne upyog kariye chhe, to e taj plant chhe. So these are all the different kind of part. Particularly when you believe that a particularly plant part or plant organs structures which you are use cure, you are curing your disease, so somehow to they give a root part, they give a stem part, they give a leaf part, either it is in a dry condition, either it in a wet crushed condition, either they are form the juice structures from that portion, either which makes us in tablet form also. So these are all the different kind of manufacture process going for the different kind of the part. In that portion, if we are going for a phytochemistry study, so first of all we need the plant part, because not having such kind of the all these parts of the plant we are going for the phytochemical study, but different kind of part. If you are take the root part, either it is take the bark part, either it is from the stem portion, either it is from the leaf portion, either it is from the flower part, either it is from the fruit part, either it is from the seed part. These are all this plant various part we are used for the study of the phytochemicals. So for that particularly plant part, if we have some little bit knowledge, because generally this knowledge we are gathering from these rural people, some tribal peoples. This science which deals with this information regarding to that portion which known as the ethnobotany, the ancient era, or maybe where the tribals, those who are living in this forest area, So there are no any kind of urban or village areas. There are no any kind of this particularly well developed home condition and well equipped home there. But the forest and trees are the home part for them. And a different kind of this plant parts, they are used. So in daily routine life, for their food, for their shelter, for their clothes, for their medicinal or the plant properties they are used. So from them, scientists like us, researchers like us, those who get the knowledge from them. And this knowledge, a little bit knowledge, which are converted into science form. Because in earlier stage, their forefathers, their elders give such information regarding to this plant in a tribal area, in a rural area. And academic person or research person like us, those who visited this area, get the information regarding to a particular plant part. But we don't know about this particular plant. We have to go for this identification, proper identification. So outside these characteristics, we find out that particular plant's name. Then after we refer these plants, either it has some kind of this information in research journals, research paper or not. But after that, we are planned to analyze all those things from that plant part. It is, if it is unknown plant also. So we take a plant parts and bring it to our laboratory, and for that plant analysis, the different kind of patterns which are used. So for that, the extraction is the foremost and first most condition for the analyze of the particularly phytochemical content. Isolation, then separation, filtration, purification, identification. Then after the identification, then analysis of the result is try for the applications. So extractions, isolation, separation, filtration, purification, identification, analysis of result and then application. These are all these various phenomena or various events which are deals with the phytochemical study. Now we move toward this medicinal plant, because the plant which having the phytochemical constituents or biomolecules within it, which having the medicinal properties, which are known as the medicinal plant. So any plant or its parts contain any substance which are useful in drug development or therapeutic level, it's called medicinal plant. So which have a drug development portion part, also the therapeutic level, if this plant having such kind of this biomolecules, so we are saying these are all these medicinal plants. The good therapeutic potential, like the presence of different bioactive constituents, either it is the primary metabolite or secondary metabolites, these are all the known as the bioactive constituents. Bioactive compounds that indicates plant have therapeutic potential and also good antimicrobial activity. So those who protect from the, some kind of these microbes to us. Important for disorder precaution and then stimulation. And medicinal plants are continuously useful as raw material, important for extraction of bioactive constituents which can be used in drug development. Generally, if we have a little bit knowledge regarding to this particular plant and plant part, if it is cured some kind of disease at such level and some area, then we are developed for the drug parts. Because we take in our laboratory, we extract it. After this extraction, the going for this filtration process, purification process, and analyzes all this biomolecules, and then we are formulating this in pharmacy or pharmacological study for the drug development. The benefits of medicinal plants, like that it has good properties to defense against various diseases. Natural products have some advantages, including low toxicity, easy availability, and cost effective. The bioactive compounds which are present in plant, it's called phytochemicals. The plant contains various bioactive constituents, including phenols, terpenoids, alkaloids, tannin, flavonoids, and glycosides. These are all these chemical constituents, all biomolecules, which are known as the secondary metabolites. The phytochemicals are important for various diseases, do not cause any side effect, and cure various diseases such as cancer, asthma, etc. Plant contain primary and secondary metabolites. So these are all these, some contain some beneficiary from that medicinal plant which have these properties. If we are have a knowledge about this metabolic activity, they are producing this some metabolites, either it is a primary, secondary or tertiary, the different kind of derivatives which we have generally in plant metabolites. Either it is a metabolism, which anabolism, catabolism activity is there. The primary metabolites generally in a, for this plant growth and development, mostly we are heard this word and we are familiar with this word, like the carbohydrate, protein, lipid, chlorophyll, amino acid, etc. So in a plant metabolite, we have primary metabolites which are known as carbohydrate, protein, lipid, chlorophyll and amino acid. But after that, for the protection for that particular living organisms, so secondary metabolites from that primary metabolites. The phenolics, terpenoids, alkaloids, flavonoids, tannins, etc. These are all these various chemical constituents which are known as a secondary metabolite. So what are primary metabolites? Primary metabolites are play perceived role in respiration, photosynthesis, translocation, nutrient assimilation and differentiation. While secondary metabolites are play role in defense against various diseases. The series of enzymes catalyze biochemical transformation occurring into the cells of organism. It's called metabolism. And this metabolism is necessary for its growth and development and also for proper response to its environment. So, physiological activity within the plant which are going on, anabolic and by the catabolic activity, the metabolic activity is there, metabolism is there, metabolites are there. So different kind of this metabolites, primary and secondary metabolites. So regarding to that, these are all this contained with the primary metabolites. There are two forms of metabolism, like this anabolism and catabolism, directly involved in growth, development and reproduction. It's called primary metabolites. While not directly involved in growth and development, but it has some ecological function, it's called the secondary metabolites. So generally for the particularly growth, development, reproductions by these primary metabolites. Here some content regarding to this secondary plant metabolites or which have the activity like this secondary plant metabolism. If we are going for their history, so it gives this in later half of the 19th century. Generally, the secondary plant metabolism were byproduct of the primary metabolism and were not crucial to the plant survival. The study of plant metabolites is thought to have started in early 1800 centuries when Friedrich Wilhelm Suttner isolated morphine from opium poppy, and after that new discoveries were made rapidly. In the early half of 19th century, the main research around secondary plant metabolism was dedicated to the formation of secondary metabolism in plants. Research was compounded by the use of tracer technique, which made reducing metabolic pathways much easier. Metabolites play an indispensable role in the survival of the plant in its environment. One of the most groundbreaking ideas of this time argued that plant secondary metabolites evolved in relation to environmental conditions, and this indicated the high gene plasticity of secondary metabolites. Recently, the research around secondary plant metabolites is focused around the gene level and the genetic diversity of plant metabolites. The biologists are now trying to trace back genes to their origin and reconstruct evolutionary pathways. So generally, from the original or origin part to the evolutionary portions where the chemical constitution are there. So most of this after the primary metabolites, if any kind of the secondary metabolites which are produced by the living organisms, and mostly likewise the plant part, so they are studied. So from that basic part, the basic structures to this application way, and not only by this only application, but regarding to this previously, the known the plant parts and up to the genes level, that back genes to their origin and reconstruct this evolutionary portion, which having this knowledge in that regarding to the secondary metabolites. The secondary metabolism produce a large number of specialized compounds, which estimate to more than 2 lakhs, that do not aid in the growth and development of plant, but are required for the plant to survive in its environment. But for their protection, for their cure, so generally, this kind of the secondary metabolite, they are produced. Secondary metabolism is connected to primary metabolism by using building block and biosynthetic enzyme derived from primary metabolism. Primary metabolism governs all basic physiological processes that allow a plant to grow and set seeds by translating the genetic code into protein, carbohydrates and amino acids. Specialized compounds from secondary metabolism are essential for communicating with other organisms in mutualistic, example, attraction of beneficial organisms such as pollinators, or antagonistic interactions, examples, detrient against herbivores and pathogens. They further assist in coping with abiotic stress such as increased UV radiation. The broad functional spectrum of specialized metabolism is still not fully understood. In any case, a good balance between products and primary and secondary metabolism is based for plant's optimal growth and development, as well as for its effective coping with often changing environment conditions. The well-known specialized compounds include alkaloids, polyphenols, including flavonoids and terpenoids. Humans use quite a lot of these compounds or the plants from which they originate for culinary, medicinal, and nutraceutical purpose. Mostly regarding to this plant tissue cultures, or maybe some biotechnology processes there, where the genetic engineering process also included. So in vitro tissue organ or cell cultures, where we have studied about the secondary metabolites. Most of the thesis works, most of the PhD research works, where the secondary metabolites and the activity, their origin, their analysis, during that this in vitro condition of that in a particularly tissue, organ or cell culture. Plant cell and tissue cultures can be established routinely under sterile condition from explant. Explant means the tissues which are taken from that particular plant part, such as plant leaves, stem, root, meristem, etc., both for multiplication and extraction of secondary metabolites. The shoot, root, callus, cell suspension, and hairy root culture are used to synthesize metabolites of interest. Metabolites which are localized in multiple tissues can be synthesized through unorganized callus or suspension culture. But when the metabolites of interest is restricted to specialized part or gland in host plant, differentiated microplant or organ culture is the method of choice. The saponin from ginseng are produced in its roots, and hence in vitro root culture is preferred for saponin synthesis. These are the examples for this saponin portion. The content of secondary metabolite production in cell culture can be enhanced by treating plant cell with biotic and or abiotic elicitors. Methyl jasmonate, the fungal carbohydrates and yeast extract are the commonly used elicitors. Methyl jasmonate is an established and effective elicitor used in the production of taxol from Taxus sinensis and ginsengoite from Panax ginseng. The most recently evolved and designed metabolic engineering can be employed to improve the productivity. The secondary metabolites of microorganisms. Microbial secondary metabolites are low molecular mass products with unusual structures. The structurally diverse metabolites show a variety of biological activities like antimicrobial agents, inhibitors of enzyme and anti-tumors, immunosuppressives and antiparasitic agents also. Plant growth stimulators, herbicides, insecticides, anti-helminthics, etc., which have this kind of properties in secondary metabolites. They are produced during the last growth phase of the microorganism. The features of microbial secondary metabolites. Generally, we are going for the subject of the plant in that particularly phytochemistry and pharmacological research, but also most of the plants, generally we are saying that it is a microorganism like structure. Mostly we think that cyanobacteria, the cyanophycin algae, also some kind of fungi which having and they produces some secondary metabolites in it, and after this production of the secondary metabolites, their activity and their properties which are very helpful to us. The principle and process of natural fermentation product synthesis can be successfully scaled up and employed to maximize its application in the field of medicine, agriculture, food and environment. The metabolite can serve as a starting material for deriving a product of interest extended further through chemical or biological transformation. The new analog or templates in which secondary metabolites serve as lead compounds will lead discovery and design of new drugs. So before the discovery of the new drugs, so this kind of exercise from extraction level to the analyze levels, we are going for that. We know the name or maybe familiar with the words with antibiotics. The discovery of penicillin initiated the researchers for the exploitation of microorganism for secondary metabolite production, which revolutionized the field of microbiology. With the advent of new screening and isolation techniques, a variety of beta-lactam containing molecules and other types of antibiotics have been identified. About 2000 antibiotics have been described Likewise, in eukaryotes, fungi are dominant antibiotic produced next to plant. In the recent year, cyanobacteria species have joined this distinguished organism as productive species. Mostly the secondary metabolite, right? It is after this metabolism activity, secondary metabolism activity, metabolites which have properties like this anti-tumor agent, natural product and its derivative account for more than 60% of anti-cancer formulation. Taxol is a non-actinobacterial molecule derived from plant Taxus gramifolia and endophytic fungi Taxomyces andreni and Neodylosporium salviformi. It interferes with microtubules breakdown, an essential event leading to cell division, thereby inhibiting rapidly dividing cancer cells. It is effective against breast and advanced from Kaposi's sarcoma. It is also found to exhibit antifungal activity against Pythium, Phytophthora and Aphidiomyces. Secondary metabolites present in various parts of the plant such as leaf, bark, stem, root, flower, etc. Usually, secondary metabolites contain various activity including biological, pharmacological and toxicological activities. Secondary metabolites have various functions for protect the human body, including defend against pathogen, boost the immune system, protect the body from free radicals. Plant secondary metabolites also play role in economic way, including in plant breeding, health and pharmaceutical plant defense against herbivores and pathogens, toxicity, antimicrobial, fragrance and attractant for pollination and also allopathic effect. Secondary metabolites also have this phytochemical present in food with nutraceutical properties, which are extensive important because of their favorable effect on human health. Thus, they protect against various disorders including cancer, diabetes, high blood pressure, inflammation, viral inflammation, ulcer, cystic disease and microbial infections. Some biological activities of phytochemicals may decrease the risk of coronary heart disease, minimize the synthesis of cholesterol, raise arterial elasticity and maintain blood pressure and clotting. There are three group dietary phenolics like flavonoids, phenolic acid and polyphenols. Here we discussed about the some secondary metabolites and which are known mostly the content of these flavonoids. Flavonoid are good antifungal and antibacterial activity against some human pathogens, fungi and bacteria. Flavonoids and tannins were displayed that active against pathogenic bacteria like Bacillus cereus, Staphylococcus aureus, etc. Flavonoids are low molecular weight polyphenolic antioxidant which are present in vegetable and fruits by naturally. Flavonoids have good anti-hyperglycemic effect. Flavonoids are helpful to improve cardiac function and minimize the cholesterol level. So generally the plant or plant part, mostly the fruit, vegetable, those who contain the flavonoids. So in our daily uses, we need to use this kind of this fruit or maybe vegetables as a raw material or maybe some kind of making of juice or maybe boil or which we are by cooked, we are having the some flavonoids in our body. The glycosides are colorless, crystalline carbon, hydrogen and oxygen containing water-soluble phytoconstituents. Based on chemical structures, glycosides contain a carbohydrate and non-carbohydrate part. We heard the name the tannin. Most of the plant parts or maybe if you are familiar with the Acacia niloteca, Acacia catechu, these are the plants which have the bark portion or some Azadirachta indica the bark portions which have a red in color. સામાન્ય રીતે આપણે કાથો કહીએ છીએ, ટેનિન હોય છે, ચા છે, ચાને ગરમ કરીએ છીએ, લાલા સ્પર્શ થઈ જાય છે, તો ટેનિન નું માત્ર એમાં વધારે હોય છે. તો ટેનિન કન્ટેનિંગ પ્લાન્ટ આર યુઝફુલ એન્ડ ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ ફોર એન્ટિસેપ્ટિક સોપ પ્રોડક્શન. ટેનિન હેઝ એન્ટી ઇન્ફ્લેમેટરી, એન્ટી ઓક્સિડન્ટ, એન્ટી માઇક્રોબિયલ પ્રોપર્ટીઝ એન્ડ હિલિંગ પ્રોપર્ટીઝ. તો ટેનિન સામાન્ય રીતે વનસ્પતિના જે ખાસ મોટાભાગના જે પ્રકાંડ હોય, પ્રકાંડની છાલ હોય, એનો ભૂકો કરી અને એમાંથી મેળવવામાં આવે છે. તો ટેનિન એ પણ એક સેકન્ડરી મેટાબોલાઇટ. ટેનિન આર હિટરોજીનસ ગ્રુપ ઓફ હાઈ મોલેક્યુલર વેઇટ પોલિફિનોલિક કમ્પાઉન્ડ, વેરી યુઝફુલ સચ એઝ ડાયસ્ટફ ઇન્ડસ્ટ્રી, ઇન ફૂડ ઇન્ડસ્ટ્રી એન્ડ પ્રોડક્શન ઓફ ઇંક. Act as a astringent, antidiarrheal, as diuretic, and also against stomach, etc. Tannin are polyphenols which are acquired from several parts of different plants belonging to multiple species. Tannins are divided into two groups: hydrolyzable tannins and condensed tannins. Tannins are present in different plant parts including root, bark, stem and outer layer of plant tissues. Tannins are water soluble and are insoluble in alcohol. Hydrolyzable tannins are also known as gallotannins or gallotannins. Because of the presence of phenolic group, tannin act as antiseptic and also it useful as healing agent and other lots of diseases. Essential oils, most of the plant parts generally during our this post corona condition, so generally the decoction potions or maybe some kind of this particularly for our nausea or maybe some kind of our nose canal tract for this clearing potion. So we take this some kind of this steam or the particularly some content of plant parts, the mint flavored or mint, we are using it. Some this Moraya panicae, it all immunogenic kahiye chhe apde. So these are the leaves which we are taking. So eucalyptus, indica or alba, the Nilgiri leaf we are taking for that part. Azadarecta indica leaf, kadavoli mudo aina pan apne lai shakiye chhe. Tulsi, osimum sanctum, these are the plants which have essential oils. Is it the volatile products of several different plant and animal species? The single volatile oil was composed in a more than 200 various chemical components. Essential oil, avashyak tel, prepared by various ways such as direct steam distillation, extraction, expression or by enzymatic hydrolyze from the different plant sources. Also, the secondary metabolites, known as the saponins, act as antifungal, also used in pesticide, detergent and molluscides. Kind of compound that occurs either steroid, alkaloids, glycosides and triterpenoids or steroids, increasing antibody production and also raising cell medicated immune system. Major group of saponin are steroid saponin and triterpen saponin. Saponins are by nature water soluble and insoluble in ethanol. Saponin has good hypolipidemic and anti-cancer activity. Phenolic compound contain one or more aromatic ring with at least one hydroxyl group. Phenols are responsible for color of fruits which occur universally as natural color pigments. It has various functions such as nutraceuticals and anti-inflammatory agents and also divided into phenolic acid, flavonoid, polyphenolic and non-flavonoid polyphenolics. Phenols are playing vital role in plant production against herbivores, pathogens and also predators because of this. Phenols are used for control of human pathogenic infections. Terpenoids having good antioxidant properties. Terpenes also called the terpenoids. These are flammable, unsaturated hydrocarbons. These biotic constituents are chemically largest class of secondary products as maintained by the number of isoprene units. Terpenoids are classified as mono, di, tri and cis white terpenoids, and it's depending on number of carbon atoms. Here the major group of that secondary metabolites, which are known as the alkaloids. Alkaloids are one of the kind of phytochemicals that is contained nitrogen and derived from the different amino acids. Alkaloids have some good activities such as anti-arrhythmic effects, anti-hypertensive effect, anti-cancer and also anti-malaria activities. Based on heterocycling ring system, alkaloids were classified in various classes including pyridine alkaloids, pyridine alkaloids, pyrrolidine, pyridine alkaloids, pyridine, piperidine alkaloids, phenolone alkaloids, isophenoline alkaloids. Alkaloids are important because it have some pharmacological activities such as anti-arrhythmic effect, anti-malarial activity, anti-hypertensive effect, anti-cancer effect. Protect the plants against pathogens and herbivores because of potent biological activity, and it also important as pharmaceuticals, narcotics, stimulants and poisons, etc. Some important examples of alkaloids of plants such as include caffeine, atropine, codeine, nicotine, morphine, cocaine, ergotamine and ephedrine. Then the steroids. Plant steroids are also called the cardiac glycosides. Small amount of the steroids stimulate the heart disease, but using more than enough, it may be cause death. Some example of plant steroids is diazoxide and cefepime from Viratum viridi. So up to this part, we have a content of this primary and secondary metabolite. This knowledge, because of the and many more that mostly the primary and secondary metabolites or their derivatives are there, because each and every plant which have this particularly derivatives of this secondary metabolite, but the little bit the knowledge and some particularly like this alkaloid or glycosides or maybe some essential oils or flavonoids, saponins. So these are the content, lignin. These are the all content which having the plant as secondary metabolites. So for that, because each and every plant part, we have this chemical constituent within in it. So for that obtaining, so from that, the isolation from that particular plant part, we are going for that. And for that, we are going for the extraction. So what is extraction? So for finding for new biomolecules, the extraction of this biotic compound, their qualitative and quantitative analysis is very essential. The separation of medicinally active portions of plant tissues separated by using selective solvent through standard process with some modification, it's called extraction. After that, produce obtained from plant in various forms such as solid, semi-solid or liquid form, which is considered for oral or external use. So various type of extraction processes like plant tissue, homogenization, serial, exhaustive extraction, salt extractions, maceration, decoction, infusion, digestion, percolation and sonication. These are all the various kind of extraction. Several parameters affect on variation of extraction methods like length of extraction period, the solvent which are used, the pH of the solvent, the temperature which are aquatic factors which are impact, plant tissue particle size, solvent to sample ratio and method for extraction. These are causes in variation in the extraction method. We are going for the cold extraction. In this method, wet or dried fresh plant parts are grind in grinder. Then add required amount of solvent mix with fine powder and shake it vigorously for a few minutes and keep it overnight for soak at room temperature. After 24 hours, filter it through Wattman paper filter number 1 and collect filtrate into petri plates and allow it still solvent evaporate and collect the extract. So these are they make by this cold extraction process. Several environmental factors like climate, rainfall, altitude, aerific factors, and some other conditions also affect on growth of plant and variation in metabolites. Qualitative and quantitative analysis of plants are important. Qualitative analysis will be useful for understanding a variety of chemicals, compounds which are produced by plants. Quantification of metabolites is useful to the extraction, identification, and purification of the bioactive compound from the extract for the aspects of human body. Here this qualitative analysis for this alkaloids and flavonoids, phenol, tannins, saponins, steroids, glycosides, carbohydrates, protein, amino acid, and various this tastes which I mentioned here. Generally you refer to some biochemical or phytochemistry book that you found that this Mayer test or maybe a ferric chloride test, lead acid test, for frozen test, Lieberman sterol test, Keller, Kelani taste is moist taste, phylin taste, Millen's taste, then hydrine taste. These are all the tests for this alkaloid. The quantitative analysis, the total phenol content or total tannin content, where this a particular amount of extract you take, then the particular amount of the Na2CO3 you have to add it there, then FC reagent you add, make final volume up to the 10 ml. Incubate for the 30 minutes in room temperature and thereafter take this OD at 760°. Qualitative and quantitative analysis, and for this tannin and phenol content before this qualitative test, if you found this such kind of condition for that particularly chemical constitution, so you go for that and you analyze these techniques. After that, this thin layer technology, also there thin layer chromatography, thin layer chromatography of particular plant, where I discuss all those contents regarding to this particularly phytochemistry and pharmacological part. So gather the, all this information from the references. But after that, there's some kind of this content which I give to you from my research area, my research student, those who have submitted their thesis and those who are going for their PhD degree. So their work which give and the particular knowledge regarding the phytochemistry. Because not only this academic portion which we have also this research part which are included in our department, and also we have some content from that parts we take. So by two students, those who are working on it, and most of the results they have not a final result we are disclosed here because of such protocols, but some kind or some types of this result which I shown to you, where this four plant they studied, like the Dahlonex regia, then Vitium monosporma, then the Citrus lemon and the Punica granitum. જેને આપણે દાડમ કહીએ છીએ, લીંબુ કહીએ છીએ, ગોલમોર કહીએ છીએ અને કેસોડો કહીએ છીએ, આ પ્લાન્ટ છે એના પર સ્ટડી કરેલો છે. દે આર ગોઈંગ ફોર ધેર પર્ટિક્યુલર રિસર્ચ. સો દે આર એપ્લાઈડ ફોર ધીસ ટીએલસી ઓફ ધેટ પાર્ટ. ધ એલિકોર્સ ઓફ એક્સ્ટ્રેક્ટ વેર એપ્લાઈડ ઓન ધ ટીએલસી પ્લેટ વિચ વોઝ 1 cm અબવ ફ્રોમ ધ બોટમ વિથ ધ હેલ્પ ઓફ કેપિલરી ટ્યુબ. ધેન ધ પ્લેટ વોઝ પ્લેસ્ડ ઇન અ ક્રોમેટોગ્રાફિક જાર એન્ડ લીડ ઇઝ ક્લોઝ. For acetone extract, chloroform, methanol, solvent system use, whereas for methanol extract, chloroform, methanol, solvent system use. Allow sufficient time for the development of spores, then remove the plates and allow them to dry. An individual RF value for each spot was measured and compared with standard reference compounds. So generally, this is a thin layer chromatography where you can use the various kind of solvent. Because not all this phytochemical constituent or content which are dissolved in a particular solutions. So like this chloroform, like this ethanol, like this methanol, petrol inhibitor, this kind of the different dissolvent which you are so dissolve this particular your plant part. Then after that, you make this result particularly of that plant, the RF value of that particular plant, of the leaf extract here. You saw that in a particular plant soil like acetone, ethanol, where the this VTM monosperma like a pseudo plant che. So in a different season, because in a different kind of season which gives a different result in it. So somehow the content of this chemical constituents or phytochemical constituents or biomolecules which are present in it, like the total phenol or total tannin, which are give the particular kind of result in it. So these are the table formation after they getting the results of the TLC here in for this plant VTM monosperma here. They are using these two solvent, acetone, ethanol, and from that part they have this RF value, and then in the late summer and the early summer condition. Also, she done her work in Dahlonex regia, and she get the results for the leaves part in two plant solvent, acetone and ethanol, and these are the result in a different kind of this season, summer monsoon, like winter and summer. So we have some differences in fish in the thing. We observe this some differences in also in Dahlonex regia. So these are the table content where this result which are having in particularly a flower part, it is in bark part, it is in leaf part, in different season. Also she takes this HPLC for that. So this HPLC system, this Kimenzo HPLC system, and these are the all this particularly content regarding to its HPLC part. Here this is a photograph of this lemon tree plant. Another girl, those who are working on this lemon and pomegranate plant, so she have this result quality dependence of lemon during two different seasons and the two different regions of Gujarat. Because in a pharmaceutical situation, so in our research work we are offering this two different places. One of the central Gujarat and other is Saurashtra, and during that portion that we have a different results we find out, and different kind of this particularly chemical constitution present in the same season, but the area is different, so which makes a differentiation in the results. So alkaloid, flavonoids, phenol, tannins, saponins, sterol, glycosides, carbohydrates, protein, these are the particularly the secondary metabolites which are tested by the various kind of tests in two different results, and we have this result. The qualitative analysis of pomegranate during these two different season and region of the Gujarat. So we have this findings in our results. Total phenol content is also we are having such result from that part. Here there's some graphical structures which has shown this particularly this lemon leaves and the lemon peels which have a different result. We have more results from this phytochemical this analysis. In the pomegranate part also we are having this phenol content of pomegranate. Here also some graphical structures and analysis of the comparison of two plant from the two different season and two different areas. Total tannin content which we are also studying from the lemon part. So two fruit, the lemon and the pomegranate, and the different part like this peels or maybe some kind of the seed portion, some leaves portion which we have, and in different season and different area we are going for the analyze this. The comparison of two tannin content from the pomegranate here. We have the graphical results and structures which emphasized knowledge regarding to this pomegranate leaves, peels and seeds. Also, we have used this FTIR, Fourier Transforms Infrared Spectroscopy, to acquire and manipulate the spectral data use of the software. The FTIR is very fast method for analysis. The discovery of IR radiation was made by Sir William Herschel in 1800. It's very good, valid and sensitive method and essential for the identification of very good range of samples. It is an alive and ability to affordable of powerful computers and fast computational algorithms which have capacity to the development of variety of application for FTIR spectroscopy. So this FTIR techniques that we have some results regarding to that which are analyzed in BTM monosperma with known as a Kesodo plant, which we have having a good result of that particular portion from that part. So we have this, the pics of that particular BTM monosperma plant from these two different regions we are analyzed. So this is the FTIR analysis of this BTM monosperma plant. We have also the FTIR of this Dahlonex region like the Gulmore plant, which have this analysis, which having this particularly the two different acetone and ethanol solvent, which have in the two other part of this particular Dahlonex region portion from this two different season, two different areas. So we have almost a very good result from that part. So FTIR analysis of the Dahlonex region and then this FTIR for this particularly BTM monosperma, which we have different plant parts, different solvent, the different areas, and we analyze these things. So we are having some result discussion in our dissertation of the PhD thesis work. We are going for that. So a little bit some slides which I share with you. Because after that research works in our department, so our students, our girls, those who are going for their degree program, PhD degree program, so she has a good analytical work within it, the plant part in the phytochemistry. The HPLC also, which we are having from that portion, because these are all these equipment which are very useful for the analysis of that or identification of the particularly biomolecules. Mostly the organic chemistry, the organic portion which we are going for that from this technique. So there are several steps in standard protocols like the stationary phase, sample application, preparation of the development solvent, development of the chromatogram, plate labeling, then derivatization and the documentation step. HPLC, which are having this application in clinical chemistry, forensic chemistry, food and drug analysis, the environment analysis for photochemistry analysis, fingerprint analysis, herbal drug quantification. The aim of HPTLC is rapid analysis of wide member of compound. HPTLC have lots of advantages such as low cost, simple method, equally analysis of samples, results obtained very fast and multiple detection were also possible. So these are all the results of the HPLC analysis of standards and where the HPLC analysis standard graph for acetone extract and also in the methanol extract where this of this gallic acid, tannic acid, ellagic acid and ascorbic acid which we are having a high peak in this particular graph in this chromatogram. We also the result of this some leaves, peels of various season in various difference like the central Gujarat and the Saurashtra region of the lemon where the lemon peels and also the lemon tree leaves we are using and these are all the results which we have. Also this is the graphical structures, the chromatogram we have of that particular leaves or maybe peels from these various different solvent like methanol and acetone. Here these are all the chromatograms by this HPLC technique. So we can identify, we can analyze this particular biomolecules from this technique. In this pomegranate also we have get the results of that part. Most of the research students and in research papers we are having it and we published four research papers of that particular part. Also, we have from the different regions. Central zone is Ahmedabad and you know Saurashtra regions. We collected this pomegranate, the leaves, and also the fruit condition and this HPLC chromatogram is which having this result. So these are the chromatogram of the different fruit part, different plant part in it. So this phytochemical study of lemon, which are having qualitative analysis, also this quantitative analysis, which have and our result, which are shown in this particular thesis. And during this her research works, we found almost good results, and we have successfully completed this phytochemical analysis part from that part. So not only in an academic way, but also in a research way, that we are going for that phytochemistry lab and the phytochemical chemistry analysis works within our department, and we are offering to the all this most of the students also having this phytochemical analysis going for this HPLC analysis technique and that part. So the four plant, Butea, then this Dahlonix, then the Punica, and this citrus lemon, this we are having this kind of the results. These are all these references which are take not only this much but many more references which are for this regarding to the study. So I hope that in this particularly ours is mostly into this 2 hours schedule time which are given by the KCG to me, and I give this most of the content regarding to plant, this plant diversities, the plant parts, and this metabolites, primary or secondary metabolites, then there is all this extraction part, then this all the analytical techniques by this TLC, HPTLC, also FTIR tactics, and we have some good results of from that research part we are getting. So I hope that listeners or participants have this particular knowledge regarding to this pharmaceutical and pharmacological this plant species research, and where this some traditional knowledge we have, but it deals with the science subject. That's which makes this more and more knowledge and more information and by this new technology. So this leading future new this technology portion webinar. So I have this opportunity to take this lecture regarding to this botany part. So thank you very much all of you.